Hey guys! So a couple weekends ago, I was puppy sitting this cutie, and they had Disney Plus, so I decided to binge watch WandaVision. And I thought they did a great job in showing the distinction of television sitcoms throughout the decades, and it inspired me to make this video. So let's just get right into it. Sitcoms, or situation comedies, have been a staple in American television for over 70 years. Not only did they make people laugh, but they also provided important messages as the world became more and more progressive. The beginning of American comedy emerged from the era of radio in the 1920s and 30s. The Jack Benny program was a very popular radio sitcom, first airing in 1932. In the late 1940s, Jack Benny decided to adapt his radio show into television, although the initial transition was panned by critics because of the difficulties going from an audio to a visual medium. However, the show found its footing and became the second longest running comedy, with its last episode airing in 1965. From the very beginning, sitcoms were pushing boundaries in social and political norms, like the Jack Benny program, having the first African-American actor play a recurring character instead of a man in blackface, which was not unusual for the time. But the Jack Benny program wasn't the first TV sitcom. Mary Kay and Johnny debuted in 1947 as a live 15-minute program on the Dumont Network, starring real-life husband and wife. And here's some trivia for you. Although it is widely believed that Lucille Ball was the first pregnant woman to be shown on television, it was actually Mary Kay in 1948 when they tried to unsuccessfully hide it, but they ended up writing it into the show. And later her son became a character. It was also the first time they showed a couple sleeping in the same bed, which would later be banned. In 1951, another radio program would be adapted into television. The radio show was called My Favorite Husband, starring Lucille Ball, and the show became I Love Lucy, starring Ball and her husband, Desi Arnaz. This show was the pioneer for the modern sitcom. Desi Arnaz decided to shoot the show on a multi-camera format on 35mm film, and since Lucy performed best when she had people to respond to, Arnaz brought in the first live studio audience. I Love Lucy aired during a time where women were expected to be wives and mothers and nothing more. However, Lucille Ball's character, Lucy Ricardo, shattered that notion by wanting and pursuing more. Although Lucy attempts to rebel against those societal rules, they always ended in a ridiculous disaster. I Love Lucy aired for 6 seasons and became one of the most popular TV shows of all time. I Love Lucy also created the rerun and syndication businesses, and Lucille Ball and Desi Arnaz became the first millionaire TV stars. The Honeymooners was first developed as a sketch for the variety show Cavalcade of Stars, portraying a couple struggling to get by in Brooklyn. The sketch developed into the Jackie Gleason Show, and in 1955 officially became the Honeymooners. The show consisted of its main protagonist, Ralph, as a get-rich-quick, scheming, short-tempered, but soft-hearted bus driver who was always striving for greatness, but never made it out of that two-room Brooklyn apartment. What made the show so attractive to viewers was its relatability. Even though the show had very high ratings, its star Jackie Gleason thought that the quality of the writing couldn't be maintained, and he and CBS decided to cancel the show after only 39 episodes. In the 1960s, 2 shows brought sitcoms into the workplace, and those were The Andy Griffith Show and The Dick Van Dyke Show. The latter show starred, obviously, Dick Van Dyke as Rob Petrie, a husband and father who works as a comedy writer for a fictional variety show. Although The Dick Van Dyke Show maintained conservative principles such as the domestic subservient wife, it also displayed subtle feminist ideas, like Rob's wife marrying capris instead of skirts, and Rob's co-worker Sally being a woman with a job. The show is known for its physical comedy and its sophisticated and witty dialogue. The show ran for 6 seasons and its high ratings never faltered. Coming off of the success of The Dick Van Dyke Show, Mary Tyler Moore, who played Rob's wife Laura, was given her own show, The Mary Tyler Moore Show, in 1970. This sitcom became a huge vehicle for feminism in the 1970s. The show portrayed a charming, independent, single working woman and her workplace family, which veered from the traditional sitcom family and created a new setting for comedy gold. The show also tackled a lot of taboo subjects such as premarital sex, birth control, equal pay, and having the first gay character. The show was so popular that 3 spin-offs resulted while the show was still in its initial run. All in the Family was one of the most controversial sitcoms and the network knew it. They even had a disclaimer before the first episode aired saying that All in the Family seeks to throw a humorous spotlight on our frailties, prejudices, and concerns by making them a source of laughter. We hope to show in a mature fashion just how absurd they are. The show revolved around Archie Bunker, a bigot who had not so wholesome opinions. Despite this, the show became a hit, and like the Mary Tyler Moore Show, it also dealt with controversial topics like infertility, menopause, and infidelity. Its spin-off series, The Jeffersons, pushed the envelope even further. The show featured an upper-class black family and remained at high ratings for all of its 11-season run. The show was able to address very serious subject matter while maintaining its comedic dexterity. The sitcom had a lot of progressive firsts, such as the first interracial couple, the first transgender character, and the first time a show dealt with suicide. In the 1980s, although most sitcoms still revolved around the nuclear family, more and more became friend-oriented or hangout sitcoms. These include Cheers, The Golden Girls, and Seinfeld. The family-oriented sitcoms also made significant changes, like Family Ties, where the parents are the liberals and the kids are the conservatives, and Married with Children and Roseanne made fun of the traditional sitcom family. Also, catchphrases became a thing during this time. In the late 1980s and early 1990s, sitcoms started to focus more on the kids' stories rather than the adults, such as Growing Pains, Full House, The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, and Boy Meets World. These shows dealt with teenage issues such as underage drinking, drugs, sex, peer pressure, and eating disorders. Other sitcoms of the 1990s continued to push boundaries, like Murphy Brown being an unmarried working mother, and Ellen coming out as a lesbian. And then there were sitcoms with no agenda at all and were just about friends living their lives. And one of those shows was Friends. Don't get me wrong, Friends did show some progressive subjects like gay marriage, transgender people, and pregnancy out of wedlock. Hangout sitcoms continued into the 2000s with How I Met Your Mother and The Big Bang Theory. However, during this time, the laugh track started to die. Curb Your Enthusiasm was one of the first sitcoms to ditch the laugh track. The 2000s also introduced the fake mockumentary sitcom, such as Arrested Development, The Office, Parks and Recreation, and Modern Family. This style did away with the multi-camera system, and instead utilized one camera with little cuts and more pans and zooms, as if one person was trying to capture all of the action. In the 2010s, sitcoms started to move away from the nuclear family, instead focusing on the lives of groups of friends, like New Girl, Community, and The Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt, or co-workers, like Brooklyn Nine-Nine, The Mindy Project, and Superstore. Later in the 2010s, older sitcoms got revivals, like Fuller House and The Conners. I can't say I know what direction sitcoms are going to go in the 2020s or what issues they're going to address. Comedy is a difficult medium that has to keep being new and innovative in order to stay funny. But maybe everyone else thought the same until somebody thought out of the box. Throughout the decades, sitcoms made humor a way for people to talk about things that were often uncomfortable to talk about, and to open minds to different ideas and perspectives. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching, and if you really enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. And if you really enjoy my content and you want to see more, please subscribe. And if you have any comments or questions or criticisms, please let me know in the comments down below. And if you have a film-related topic that you want me to cover, please let me know that as well. I'm always open to new ideas. And I will see you guys next time. Bye!